Cell. Cell, it is a Latin word. Cell means a little room. A little room. It is a Latin word. Means, suppose we are in this classroom, we can say a cell. But in English, cell means a little room. In Latin, it is a word cell, which in English means a little room. A little room, okay? But in science, what is a cell? First, cell was observed by Robert Hooke. Robert Hooke in the year 1665. In the year 1665, Robert Hooke first discovered a cell. He used a simple microscope and he observed that a honeycomb structure is present in a thin slice of corn. He viewed a thin slice of corn and he saw honeycomb like structure. He saw many compartments in that thin slice of corn. He named those compartments as cell. That means a little room. Okay? So now the literal meaning of cell is clear that it means a little room. It is a Latin word and it means a little room. And firstly it was observed by Robert Hooke in the year 1665. Okay? So next topic is our cell theory. Next topic is our cell theory. What is cell theory? Every living organism is composed of cells. Either it is plants or animals, every living organism is made up of cells. Cell is the smallest unit of life. Cell theory proposes that number one, these two theories were proposed by Sladen and Swan. Sladen and Swan proposed the cell theory. All living organisms are composed of cells. Cell is the smallest unit of life. And later it was extended by Virchow. Virchow said, all cells arise from pre-existing cells. All cells arise from pre-existing cells. It means the parent cell goes under division. There are two types of division in cell. We see mitosis and meiosis division. Okay, we will discuss about mitosis and meiosis in later classes. What are telophage, anaphage, metaphage? What is vegetative cell? We will discuss it in later classes. Now you have only to know that there are two kinds of cell division, mitosis and meiosis. And parent cell undergo division to form daughter cells. Parent cell undergo division to form daughter cells. So the new cells arise from pre-existing cells. It was explained by Virchow. Virchow said all cells arise from pre-existing cells. This is the cell theory. These are the three points of cell theory, and it is a very important topic. Cell theory, cell is clear. Now we will discuss what is a cell in more detail. let's discuss about what is cell in more detail. Cells are building blocks of life. All living matters are composed of cells. Onion, potato, every fruit, vegetable, leaf, root, stem, every part of plant, every part of human body is made up of cells. Our nails, our hair, our skin, our organs, all things are made up of cells. Cells makes us. Cells are our building blocks. Okay? So, cells can be of two types. It can be prokaryotic. And eukaryotic. It can be prokaryotic and eukaryotic. Already we see that cell came from Latin word which meant a little room. Here prokaryotic is composed of three words. There are pro, karyo, and live. Eukaryotic, eu and karyon. Eu plus karyon. These are Latin words. Karyon means nucleus. Karyon means nucleus. So, and pro means primitive. Pro means primitive. Primitive, you can say primitive as underdeveloped or not very well defined. So, primitive nucleus, those organisms that has primitive nucleus are called prokaryotic. U can be said as new and karyon is nucleus. So we can say that eukaryotic organisms are the organisms which have new nucleus, which have well developed nucleus, which have defined nucleus. Okay, so we will make point-wise difference between the prokaryotic and eukaryotic. First difference is in their meaning and their name. The prokaryotic and eukaryotic. Prokaryotic means primitive karyon and eukaryotic means well developed new nucleus. Okay. So we will write down more difference points between the eukaryotic and the prokaryotic. First difference, what difference? We will write here the characters and then we will differentiate between the two. Okay. First we will talk about size. What is the size of prokaryotic organisms? What is the size of eukaryotic organisms? Prokaryotic organisms ranges from 1 to 10 micrometers in size and eukaryotic organisms ranges from 5 to 500 micrometers in size. Micrometer, 1 micrometer is equals to 10 to the power minus 6 meter. Okay? 1 micrometer, it is also called micron, it is equal to the value 10 to the power minus 6 meter. So prokaryotic are very small, comparatively very small organisms, whereas eukaryotic are bigger than the prokaryotic. Okay, so first of all, the size of prokaryotic organisms, they are very small and eukaryotic are comparatively bigger in size. Next, we will discuss about the nucleus. Nucleus. Here in prokaryotic we have already discussed that pro means primitive, karyon means nucleus, means it has primitive nucleus, it has undefined nucleus, it has underdeveloped nucleus. We can say the nucleus is poorly defined. The nucleus lacks nuclear membrane, it doesn't have the membrane and sometimes it only has nucleic acid. Therefore it is also called nucleoid. Okay, so nucleus poorly defined. Poorly defined, we can also say that it is not very well defined, it is undefined, it is primitive. Nucleus is very poorly defined. Here in eukaryotic organisms, nucleus is well defined. Nucleus is well defined. In prokaryotic organisms, the nucleus is poorly defined, whereas in eukaryotic organisms, nucleus is well defined. Okay, so next, nuclear membrane. Nuclear membrane. The prokaryotic organisms lack nuclear membrane, whereas eukaryotic organisms have double layered nuclear membrane. Okay, lacks nuclear membrane. Lacks nuclear membrane. Double layered nuclear membrane is present. Double layered nuclear membrane. if we discuss about the